हेलो एवरीवन, सो टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन असिम्प्टोटिकली रेगुलर मैपिंग्स। व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय असिम्प्टोटिकली रेगुलर मैपिंग्स? अ मैपिंग एफ गोइंग फ्रॉम डी टू डी इज सेड टू बी असिम्प्टोटिकली रेगुलर इफ फॉर ईच एक्स बिलोंगिंग टू डी द लिमिट ऑफ एफ टू द पावर एन एक्स माइनस एफ टू द पावर एन प्लस वन एक्स नॉर्म दिस नॉर्म इज गोइंग टू जीरो एज एन गोज टू इन्फिनिटी। So here D is a subset of a Banach space X and F is a mapping on this subset. Then this mapping is said to be asymptotically regular if this condition holds for each X belonging to D. What we observe? We observe that if D is bounded and convex and T is any mapping going from D to D which is non-expansive, then the mapping F is identity plus T by 2 having the same fixed point set as T. Now we can easily show this thing. Let's suppose X be any fixed point of T. If X is a fixed point of T, it means T of X is equal to X. Now we will find out the value of F at X. It will be I plus T times this thing at X by 2, right? So that means I at X means X identity mapping means it is X plus T of X. Now since X is a fixed point of T, so therefore this is again X. So we get X plus X by 2 which is X. So this implies that X is a fixed point of F. Right? So therefore the mapping which is defined like this has the same fixed point set as the mapping T. Also, F is asymptotically regular, means this condition holds. And you can verify this thing by substituting the values of F to the power n and F to the power n plus 1. Right? It will be comes out in the terms of T to the power n and T to the power n plus 1. And we can show that this is asymptotically regular. So next we will prove lemma. And that lemma says, suppose xn and yn, these are the sequences in the Banach space X which satisfy these two conditions. Then for all I and n belonging to the natural number, this inequality holds. Now these two conditions are, the sequence xn and yn are defined like this, that we have a recursive relation that xn plus 1 is equal to half of xn plus yn, and the norm of yn plus 1 minus yn is less than equal to the norm of xn plus 1 minus xn. So these are two conditions, and then this inequality holds. We will prove this inequality by induction. So in the case 1, we take n to be 0 and vary I varying from 1, 2, 3 and so on. What will we have? The left hand side is the norm of yi minus xi, and in right hand side when you put n to be 0, it is again yi minus xi norm. This n is 0, this n is 0, this n is 0. So this will be cancelled out and you left with only 1. So it means it trivially holds for n is equal to 0. So we can assume that this inequality holds for some given n and for all I, and this is this inequality. In this inequality we replace I with I plus 1, right? And this we assume that this inequality holds for some given n. Now we need to show for n plus 1, right? So first we observe that the norm of yi n plus 1 minus xi plus 1 norm, it will be less than equal to this plus this. Now how? By using the 1, we can substitute the value of x of I plus 1 which is half of xi plus yi. Right? And using norm, since we know that the norm of a plus b is less than equal to the norm of a plus norm of b, so we can separate these two terms. We can write yi n plus 1 as yi n plus 1 by 2 plus y I n plus 1 by 2. One we combined with x I and other combined with y I. Right? So this is less than equal to half of the norm of this plus half of the norm of this. Further, we can write this norm as in the terms of summation by using the triangle's inequality. We'll add and subtract yi terms, right? So this norm will be less than equal to this plus this plus this plus this and so on. So we can write in the terms of summation by using the triangle's inequality, right? And further, by using the second assumption, second condition, the norm of this is less than equal to the norm of x size. So we can replace with this. So we get this norm is less than equal to this norm. Further, we will combine this and this inequality. So combine the with the previous inequality, we will have this inequality. Right? Now just see, further we will multiply with 2 to both sides. So this is twice times this. This will become 2 to the power n plus 1 and this half will be removed. Next we observe that from the condition 1 and 2 that norm of yn plus 1 minus xn plus 1 norm, it will be less than equal to the norm of, we can add and subtract yn. So it will be less than equal to this norm plus this norm, right? But by using the second, it should be less than equal to the norm of xn plus 1 minus xn norm, right? So we get this. And again, we can combine these two. Xn plus 1, xn plus 1 will be cancelled out. So we will left with yn norm minus xn norm. So it should be less than equal to this. So what we have, that this sequence is monotonically decreasing sequence, right? Now we will find out the value of this summation, which we will get in the previous slide in the inequality. So we will find out the value of this summation. It will be half of the norm of yi plus k minus xi plus k. We can substitute the value of xi plus k plus 1 from first equation. It will be half of xi plus k plus yi plus k, right? And we can write half of, so we will get this. So it is a half will be cancelled out with this, so we will have this norm. But using this above one, we know that this is less than equal to this, right? So each time when we replace this with the yi minus xi norm, we will get it is a summation of 1 going from k 0 to n. So that means it is n plus 1. So this summation is less than equal to n plus 1 by 2 times the norm of yi minus xi. So we can substitute the value of this in the previous inequality. We can replace, we can put the value of this. And further, after simplifying the terms, we will have this inequality which we want to show. So this proves the result. Now this is the main result of this section. This says that let K be a bounded convex subset of a Banach space, and suppose T is a mapping going from K to K which is non-expansive, and then the mapping F going from K to K defined by setting this identity plus Tx by 2, it is asymptotically regular. In the proof of this main theorem, we will use the lemma. So to apply the lemma, first we find out the sequences. So we consider any point of this k, call this point as x0, and corresponding to this x0, we will find out y0, which is f of x0. And we can define further xn, then yn in the terms of xn and xn plus 1 as this recursive relation. So now we can apply the lemma. And the lemma says then for each I and n belonging to the natural number, this inequality holds. Now take I now just see, since norm of xn minus yn is a monotone decreasing sequence, therefore the limit of this will be some r. That means this sequence is convergent and let it converging to r. So in the above inequality, if I put I to be infinity, what we have, this is going to r, this is going to r, this is going to r, and here it is you can add and subtract xi plus n, and it will be going to r plus the diameter of k. Now just see, the norm of xi plus n minus xi, that gives us the, when n goes to infinity and I goes to infinity, it will be the max distance between the two points. So that is the diameter. Since these are the points of k, so it will give us the diameter. So this is the diameter of the k, right? So what we have this is less than equal to r plus k, and 1 r will be cancelled out. You left with n by 2 times r is less than equal to diameter of k. Since it is true for each n, so it is also true for very very large n, that means n going to infinity. But diameter of k cannot be greater than equal to infinity because k is a bounded set. So this is a contradiction, right? So it means this inequality will hold only when r is 0. And this thing we have to prove, that fx is asymptotically regular. So this completes the proof of main result. Thanks.